Welcome back to my channel. In the previous video, we have been discussing about the WordPress site making from scratch. If you have missed the video, the link is given in the description. You may go and get the video. So in this video, we are going to speak about the Python keywords and identifiers which are going to play a very major role in Python programming. So first, let us define the keyword. Keyword is a reserved and predefined word in Python that have a special content or a special place. Keywords are used to define the syntax of coding. The keyword cannot be used as an identifier, function, and variable name. All the keywords are written in lower cases are expected as true and false. So this will be lying between true and false. There are 33 keywords in Python 3.7. So as I have said, there are 33 keywords in Python 3.7. So 3.7 is the latest version of the Python. So I have also some editors for Python which I will be discussing in the next video. You can use online GDB compiler or Spider or PyCharm compiler. One is AND. This is a logical operator and will return true if the both operands are true, else will return to false. So this is a logical, AND is a logical operator which will return true if the both operands are true. So if the both cases which we have assigned are true, then our value is true, or else it will return to false. Or this is a logical operator will return true if any one of the operand is true, else will return to false. The second case is very simple. The value is true or else it will return to false. The next one is NOT. This is a logical operator will return true if the operand is false, else will return false. So if the operand is false, then it will return true or else it will return false. The next one is if. It is used as a conditional statement. Here's an example. If my number is greater than 25, print true. So for the next case also, I have given the example here only. Now greater than 25, then the condition is false. So by demonstrating an example previously, we'll give you an idea for the next one. So elif. Elif is a conditional statement used with if statements. The elif statement is executed if the previous statements are not true. So the previous example, we have said that my number is greater than 25 and I have printed a condition to be true. Case, we have said elif print false. So I hope you got clarity on the both if and elif conditional statements. The next one is else. Else is used with if and elif conditional statements. This else block is executed if the condition is not true. So if this both conditional statements, if and elif are true, then our else is not executed. If they're false, then it is executed. The next one is for. This keyword is created for a loop. So if we want to create a loop, we are going to use a for loop. So in order to create a for loop, we need to invoke this specific keyword. The next one is while. The same case, we are replacing the for keyword by while. The next one is break. This is used to terminate the loop. So if we want to end or break our loop there, then we are going to use the break. As we have seen in the C programming case, we have broke a statement or a line there and just moved on to the next line by using the break keyword. So the next one is as. This keyword is used as an alternative. So if we want to use any substitute in our program, then we are going to use this specific keyword and get our work done. The next one is this keyword is used to define a function. So if we go to define a function, we use in this keyword def. The next one is lambda. This keyword is used for defining an anonymous statement. So if you want to define any statement x, then we are going to use this specific function or keyword lambda. The next one is pass. This keyword is a null statement, which means that it does nothing. So if we are going to invoke this specific keyword, then this is denoted as a null statement and it will not do nothing. Then this is not going to be priority by the compiler. The next one is return. It will return to a statement or value and will end the program. So by invoking the specific statement key return, then our value is going to a value is going to end and our program will be terminated. The next one is true. This keyword is a boolean value. So true and false or some boolean values, which will be only for the conditions when we are going to apply them. The next one is false. This is also a boolean value, try. This keyword makes try expect statement. So try and error the same. So if we want to try some try invoking some keywords, then we'll just invoke this specific keyword. The next one is with. This keyword simplifies exceptional handling. So now let us define the exceptional handling. Exceptional handling. An exception is an event which occurs while performing a program, which disrupts the normal flow of the program. So the specific exception is going to occur when we are going to perform a program. This will also disturb our normal flow and will deviate our path. In Python, when a situation occurs, when Python also cannot cope with the situation, then we are going to raise an exception. So this exception will represent the error and get it rectified. The next one is assert. This keyword is used for debugging purposes, which checks the correctness of the code. So this specific keyword is used when we are going to debug a program and check whether there are any bugs in our program or not. The next one is class. Helps us to define a class. So by using this keyword, we can define a class. The next one is continue. This keyword is used to continue to next iteration of the code. So if we want to write some more statements which are repeated, then this specific keyword can be used. So iteration does the same. This is a repeated set of statement is called iteration. The next one is del. It deletes a reference to the object. So it will delete a reference. A reference in the sense it is going to be a starting point or a specific point where we are going to define a program. The next one is except. Used with exceptions, what to do when an exception occurs. So we are going to define the specific keyword when we are going to provide an exception to the program. So it's quite confusing. We'll be executing and getting a perfect clarity on this specific keyword. The next one is finally. This keyword is used with exceptions where the code will be executed no matter an exception occurs not. So by using this specific keyword finally, our program or code will be run. Either we are going to invoke an exception or not, but this occurs with exceptions. So the exception may be true or false. The compiler will not care anything and just run the program and get our work done. The next one is from. This part is used to import facts in any module. So keyword is used to declare a global variable. The next one is import. This keyword is used to import a module. The next keyword is in. This keyword is used to check whether a value in the list, tuple, etc. or not. So this specific keyword in is used to check whether a value in the list, tuple, etc. is correct or not correct. So tuple is something which is used to invoke multiple statements into a single variable. The next keyword is. This keyword is used to check whether the two variables are equal or not. So by using this keyword, we can check whether the two variables are equal or not. So in C, we have executed this for not equal, and for equality we just tried to use this symbol. So in Python, we are going to invoke the is keyword and get our work done without using this symbol. So the next one is null. This keyword is a special constant used to denote a null value or a void value. So by defining a none, you can denote a null value or a void value. Void value in the sense you'll not return to anything. A null value is a zero value. Non-local. This keyword is used to declare a non-local variable. The next one is raise. This keyword is used to raise an exception. The next one is yields. This keyword is used to end a function and return to a generator. So this is it for this tutorial. The Python identifiers will be discussing in the next video coming. So the content, you may visit my website. And if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting updates on programming.